Good morning, children. How are you all? Fine? Good. My name is Gayatri, English teacher of Dr. Besant School. Today we are going to do our second standard English subject. Are you all ready with your studio books, children? Yes? As I already told you, be ready with your studio books. So I want everyone to open your studio books. Today we will finish our lesson 2 explanation part. So children, what was the lesson we were doing? The web of life. The web of life. And what is the subheading in this? The king and the spider. The king and the spider. Yes or no, children? Yes. So now, open your studio books, page number 18. Once, I want everyone to put your finger on the lines. I will read the story, then I'll explain you the balance lesson. Right, children? So put your finger on the lines. The King and the Spider. There was a king named Robert Bruce. He lived in Scotland. He lost his country in a war. He ran away to save his life. He was all alone. King Bruce reached a forest. He went inside a cave. He was sad and hungry. He thought, I have no country. I have lost everything. There is no hope. King Bruce saw a spider in the cave. It was trying to spin a web. There was a strong wind. The web tore. The spider tried again. Again a strong wind blew. The spider fell down. It got up and started spinning the web again. This happened many times. The king said, "Oh, little spider, you should give up. The wind is too strong for you." However, the spider did not give up. It tried spinning the web 6 times. Each time the wind tore the web. The 7th time the spider finally built its web fully. This time the web was strong. It did not tear even when a strong wind blew. King Bruce thought, the little spider tried so hard. It is very brave. How can I give up so easily? I should fight back. He told the spider, "You taught me a great lesson today. Thank you." Right, children? So what was the story we read yesterday? There was a king named Robert Bruce. And he lived in a country called Scotland. And once there was a war between two countries. In that war, King Bruce lost his Scotland, his country. And he lost all his property, he lost everything. So he ran from that war to save himself, to save his life. By running, he reached a forest. In that forest, he went to a cave and he sat in the cave thinking himself that, I lost everything in my life. I lost my country. There is no hope for me. What should I see and leave leave now? He was thinking himself. At that time, he saw a spider in the cave. The spider was spinning a web. Spinning means, oka web tana spider web ni tayar chesukuntundi. While spinning, what happened? A great wind blew. Because of that wind, the web tore. But the spider did not give up. Again, it started spinning. Once again, the wind blew. At that time, it was so high and the spider fell down. And the web also tore again. But the spider still did not give up. And started spinning again. Like this, it happened many times. Then what happened, you see, children? Then the king said, by seeing all this, "Oh, little spider, you should give up." What he said? "Oh, little spider, why are you trying so many times? You are trying, the wind is tearing your web. Again you are trying, what is the use? You just leave it. You take another place and go there and start spinning. The wind is too strong for you. You are so a light insect you are. The wind is so strong. You can't cope up with that wind. You can't fight with that wind. You just leave that web and go away. But what the spider did, you see now. However, the spider did not give up. Even though the king was saying that, the spider was not willing to give up, was not willing to leave that. He tried and tried. He tried spinning the web 6 times. How many times it happened like that, Amma? It happened for 6 times. Every time the wind was blowing, the web was tearing. The same thing was happening. Each time the wind tore the web. Every time the wind was tearing the web, tore the web. The 7th time, the spider finally built its web fully. But the 7th time, what happened? It started spinning a strong web so that even the wind blows, nothing will happen to the web. But that last time, after 6 times, the 7th time, the spider could build its web. This time the web was strong enough. The web was strong. It did not tear even a strong wind blew. What happened, Amma? This time the spider got some idea. Why is happening like this? I should do something else to come out with this strong wind. And he started spinning the web a bit strong. So what happened? Even the wind blew very strong, the web was standing without falling down. So the spider won, right? It won against the strong wind. King Bruce thought, this little spider tried so hard. Yes or no? The spider was such a small insect. It started fighting with a heavy wind. But at last, it only won. It is very brave. It is so sharp, brave, courageous, means healthy, strong enough. How can I give up so easily? Are you such a small insect? Fought with such a big strong wind and won. And how could I leave? Why I left my country and ran away? I might have fought with the other country people for some more time to get my country back. Why I ran away? He felt shame on his part. I should fight back. I should go back now. And I should fight. I ran away and I came, so that fellow, the other king, happily took the country easily, very easy way. But if he might have fought for some more time, chances he could have won on that king, right? So he thought, I should go back and fight. He told the spider, you taught me a very good lesson, a very great lesson today. Thank you so much. Because of you only I learned that we should not give up. Eppudu kuda raavatledu ani odilekoddu. We should try and try till we succeed, till we get. Even you see, when you are learning something, small answers you will easily learn. You learn by heart everything and easily write. If the answer is for 2 to 3 lines extra, what you do? But many times I am reading, I am unable to remember. Just throw here, that, here, that. You leave reading. But if you try. 2 times you will read, you will not get. 3 times you will read, you will not get. But if you read for 5 times, 10 times, some or the other time you will learn that answer, right? So from this lesson, what you all learned, children? We should never give up. Try and try till we win.
You have to try
in a wholehearted way. Idu try chestunnam kada ani chadavastunnanu ante kaadu. You should keep all your concentration on that and learn. Then only you can learn properly. What is the use? You'll think somewhere, you'll write here. What is the use out of that? No use. If you keep all your concentration, even the spider, ikkada aalochinchukoni web vesinanko ledu. It can't keep its web, right? It was thinking, what should I do? What should else I do? She was thinking of ideas. At last, it started spinning a strong web. Then the web was standing continuously. So I think, children, everyone understood the story. So once again, put your fingers on the lines. I'll read the story once again. If you have any doubts, just note down the doubts. I think you all are clear with your doubts now. But still, if you have any doubts, note down on a paper. Whenever we have a Zoom interaction, you can clear them now, right? So once again, put your fingers on the lines from the starting of the story and listen, children. There was a king named Robert Bruce. He lived in Scotland. He lost his country in a war. He ran away to save his life. He was all alone. King Bruce reached a forest. He went inside a cave. He was sad and hungry. He thought, I have no country. I have lost everything. There is no hope. King Bruce saw a spider in the cave. It was trying to spin a web. There was a strong wind. The web tore. The spider tried again. Again a strong wind blew. The spider fell down. It got up and started spinning web again. This happened many times. The king said, "Oh, little spider, you should give up. The wind is too strong for you." However, the spider did not give up. It tried spinning the web 6 times. Each time the wind tore the web. The 7th time, the spider finally built its web fully. This time, the web was strong. It did not tear even when a strong wind blew. King Bruce thought, "This little spider tried so hard. It is very brave. How can I give up so easily? I should fight back." He told the spider, "You taught me a great lesson today. Thank you." So children, I think you all are clear with the story. So let us do now. Look deep. 2.2 now. 2.2. Right. What did King Bruce learn from the spider? Discuss. Means you have to see. Tell me, we need to discuss on this. No need to write. Tell me children, what did the King Bruce learn from the spider? He learned that we should never give up and we should try again and again, even though we'll get many beatings, we'll fall many times, but we should try and try again and again to reach the goal. Yes or no, children? That only we learn. That only we learn, children. Yes, the king also learned the same. So see now, next. Take the lines from the story that tell you this. You may choose more than one. From this also you'll get the answers. I'll write the sentences on the board first. Then we'll tick. The spider, put your, be ready with your pencils, children. The spider did not give up. The little spider did not try hard. Did not try hard. The spider is very brave. The spider is very brave. The spider is lazy. The spider showed the king that he must fight back. So you got 6 boxes here. You should put a tick mark for the correct and wrong for the wrong sentence. Right? So see children. Now, the spider did not give up. Yes or no, she did not give up. It was trying, even though the spider was falling down, the web was tore again and again it was trying. So the spider did not give up. Right, put tick mark in that box, first box. Completed. Next, the little spider did not try hard. It did not try hard. Here it tried very hard. It tried very hard. So, but he is saying he did not try very hard. So it is a wrong sentence. Put wrong in the second box. Put wrong in the second box. Now, the spider is very brave, talented, strong, courageous. Yes or no? For that only, it was not giving up and it was trying again and again to get to spin a web. So it is a right sentence. Put a tick mark in the third box. Put a tick mark in the third box. Next, the spider is lazy. Lazy in the sense it will not willing to do. Once it will fall down, okay, let it go. I can't do any more. All the time it will pass on its time. It is doing like that. The spider was doing like that. No, it was trying very hard. It was a hard worker. So the sentence was wrong. Put a wrong there. Next, completed. Last one. The spider showed the king that he must fight back. By seeing that spider only, even though many times it fall down, it was trying again and again. The king learned that I should not leave my country. I should go and fight back and I should get my country back. He thought like that because of that spider only. So the sentence is right. Put a tick mark there. Put a tick mark there, children. Yes? Completed? So shall I rub the board, children? Yes. Right. Same, so open page 20. Same 2.2, page 20. There is a question, right? We have to answer now. Describe the lesson that the King Bruce learned. What King Bruce learned? He told like then, I learned a lesson from you. You taught me a great lesson today. So what is that lesson? You have to write, children. I want everyone to write very small letters because the place will not be sufficient. So write in small letters, children. Here they gave you some lines, note down on the lines you have to write. So remember, children, sharp your pencils. Touch the line and write. Give finger gap properly. Every time give finger gap after every word. Touch the line and write. Automatically your handwriting looks good. Give finger gap. Touch the line. Sharp your pencils. Everything should be done neatly. Then automatically your handwriting looks good. See now. King Bruce learned from the spider. See how I am giving finger gap everything, children, in the same way. You should also give finger gap, touch the line and write. To keep trying and not to give up. And not to give up easily. See, everywhere I'm giving finger gap. Shake, children. Yes or no? And even if you observe, I'm touching the line and I'm writing. Automatically, handwriting looks good. Sharp your pencils and write. He also learned that. He also learned that he should be brave. He should be brave and fight back. And fight back for his country. For his country. Yes or no? King Bruce learned from the spider to keep trying, not to give up easily. We should try and try, try and try. At last, if we can't, there is nothing in our hands, we can leave it. But still, till then we have to try. Yes or no, children? He also learned that he should be brave. Means he should think spontaneously, very courageously, very strong. And fight back for his country. So children, note down fastly. Children, every time I'm telling you, again I'm telling you the same. Pause the video and write. So that I can't give you the complete time how much you want for writing, no? So you just pause the video and finish writing. If not like that also, I'll send you the PDF of this paper so that you can copy from that also, children. No need to worry. But remember one thing only, sharp your pencils and write. Give finger gap properly. Touch the line and write neatly, slowly. Take your own time. If you pause now, you can take your own time and write. Completed, children? Done? I think you all completed. Yes. So write, children. Tomorrow also we are going to do studio book only, question time part. So I wish everyone to be ready with your studio books tomorrow. Pencil eraser sharpener with sharp pencil and water bottle. So children, if you have any doubts in today's class, please note down your doubts on a paper and ask me at the Zoom time. I'll meet you in the next class. Till then, take care and bye-bye.